Thank you very much, Jay, and thank you very much for Knowledge Train for giving me this opportunity to speak in front of this wonderful crowd. So today I will be talking about the rise of AI, how AI is revolutionizing the project management. This is not something that will happen in future. This is something happening right now, today, and we will see that how we can do this in a live demo in 20 minutes from now, right? So let's just stay there. So before I get started, let me just make sure my slides are working. Yes, they are. There we go. My name is Mashhood Ahmed. I'm a certified human. I'm not a robot. I'm not a hologram. I'm a real person, right? So if you would like to connect with me, you can scan the QR code, go to my LinkedIn profile and connect with me on LinkedIn. About my work, I have over 20 years of project management consulting and program management experience, worked across in US, Canada, and Middle East. I got my PMP certification back in 2008, so I'm an old guy with a PMP certification. Got my master's from University of Waterloo, and a few years back, I challenged myself to do something different, and that was speaking engagement and speaking in front of the crowd. That took me all over the world. I've been to South Africa, Tanzania, New Zealand, Singapore, you know, Pakistan, US and Canada, so many places within US and Canada that I cannot even count. So that's been my experience, and I do volunteer for PMI, ISACA, and a couple of other volunteer organizations. So I highly recommend all of you to volunteer in whatever capacity you can, because that's how we give back to the society, right? So that's a good side of our humanitarian side. So with that, you know, connect me on the LinkedIn if you would like to, and we'll just get into the topic. Before I get started, I usually start my talk with patterns. And the reason I like to talk about patterns is because patterns are everywhere. They tell us very important lessons in life, right? They tell us what's gonna happen, how to map the pattern, how to see the pattern. So our goal is to understand the pattern, follow the pattern, either break the pattern or make new patterns so that we are getting the edge from those patterns. So learning from patterns, let's just look at Industrial Revolution. So first Industrial Revolution that lasted over 150 years was about moving people from agricultural society to the industrial society. So that was a time when, you know, agriculture industry saw like a farming equipment, tractor trailers, and then we see the mechanization, we saw the steam, water power, some railroad network and things like that, okay? That was 150 years long time frame. Then after World War II, we get into second industrial revolution up until late 80s, early 90s. And that was all about mass production, assembly line, electricity, power grid, road network, rail network, aeroplanes flying all over the place. And that lasted about 60 to 65 years, depending how you calculate that time frame. And then in early 90s, we get into the computer and automation. In mid 90s, we saw the birth of internet and we got like connected devices. People start talking, communicating. And then that lasted about like 30 plus years now, where we are today in 2024, we are looking at cyber physical system, AI, nanotechnology, neural network, and other new technologies. So the important lesson here is twofold. One, the time it takes for industrial revolution is shrinking, and the innovation growth that is happening in each industrial revolution is much higher than before. That means it is very important for us to understand and learn these new technologies and new things as they come along to us. And also, we are the first generation who will experience multiple industrial revolutions in our lifetime. What I mean by that, somebody, you know, like our parents, right? Most of our parents born in 1940s or 50s, you know, and they spent their whole career in one industrial revolution, right? They stayed there, or they did some little bit of a change and it was okay for to adopt. But we are the first generation that will see multiple industrial revolution, meaning this fourth industrial revolution will be much shorter and the innovation growth here will be much faster that we can catch up. With all things happening in generative AI, it's impossible for anybody to catch up with all the things that are happening up there. So what is important here is from these patterns is to have the important skill set. And I would like to talk about two skill sets that are very important. These are not technological skill set. These are pure human skill set. Number one is our ability to unlearn. We need to unlearn the old ways of doing things, and we need to unlearn our old habits and old patterns. Then we need to supplement this with our ability to relearn, right? So we need to relearn the new way, we need to adapt to the new ways of doing things, and we need to build our new habits so that we can have this continuous improvement throughout our life. So this is very important, right? So we need to unlearn how we do things, and we need to relearn the new way, and we need to be okay with not knowing everything that is happening in the technology or the business, because it's just humanly not possible to catch up with all the new innovation and the growth that is happening at the speed of the light. So with that, I'm going to move into the definition of AI. I believe everybody has seen some definition of AI. Everybody has a good understanding of what AI is, right? But for me, it is simple, which is it's the ability for the computers to perform tasks that normally requires human intelligence or to imitate intelligent human behavior, such as problem solving, learning, reasoning, giving the logical, having a logical discussion, right? Visual perception, looking at the picture, the dog or a cat, recognizing voice. Is this a male voice or a female voice? Is this like a European accent, Australian accent, or an American accent, right? So having that recognition in different languages. And then we can put like a large amount of data and patterns into this AI engine that can analyze this and give us the more intelligent results that we are looking at. So with that, I will talk about the AI categories at the very high level. So the first one is generative AI that can generate the content. It can generate the image. It can generate the videos. It can generate the voice. Any content that we are trying to play with generative AI is an example of generative AI. Further, generative AI can also build the context. That means it can infer from the information what is not being said and kind of fill those gaps. And when it does, sometimes it does it correctly, other time it does not correctly, and it causes the hallucination. The next one is the specialized AI, which is like a narrow AI that can do something very, very specific. So the example I typically give is in healthcare, radiologists have been using AI to look at the images and see if there's a cancer or if what type of problems are there, right? So this is like image recognition kind of a problem. And what we could do is we can look at the image and say, yes, this patient has 80% chance of cancer, this patient does not, right? So, and vice versa. And then we have hybrid AI that can combine the both. So what happened when we combine them both? So the same example of medical diagnosis. Now the doctors can say, okay, this patient has cancer cell. If I treat this patient with this medication or this therapy, what would be the outcome? How the cancer will shrink, how it will impact the patient body, because you know cancer medications affect the human body very dangerously, right? So we need to keep a balance up there. And that's an example of a hybrid AI where you can use specialized AI, put the layer of generative AI, images, pictures, and other details, and see what the scenario or the simulation may look like. So some of the research finding, I just put these two research finding on one slide. I'm pretty sure all of you have seen this one. AI will not replace humans, but humans with AI will replace human without AI. Now, if you take this same statement 100 or 200 years back, the farming equipment will not replace the farmers, but the farmer who use the farming equipment will replace the farmer who do not use the farming equipment. Okay, so you replace AI with the technology of first industrial revolution, second industrial revolution. This statement remains the same. That means we need to learn and we need to adopt the AI and move forward. The second one from 2019, Gartner research finding, that says 80% of today's project management tasks will be eliminated by 2030 as AI takes over. It is not saying 80% of project management function or project managers, it's saying 80% of project management tasks. Let me ask this question to this, we have about 47 people here. Is there anyone in this room who loves to take the meeting minutes as a project manager, who enjoys to taking the meeting minutes? Do we have anyone? I haven't found one yet. Somebody says, haha, no way, right? So that's the problem. I see some thumbs down. There we go. So I have done this talk or similar talk to like thousands of project managers across the globe. I haven't found a single project manager who loves taking meeting minutes. And this is exactly what we will do today. We will have like a meeting minutes. We'll put into ChatGPT and Google Gemini. You'll see some results and we will play with it to see what else we can do. Okay. So with that, I'm going to talk about why all of this is happening right now, because AI is not a new terminology. It's first was discussed by Alan Turing in 1950s, right? So it's been in the academic topic for last 80, 90 years almost now, right? 70, 80 years. However, now today we have the better algorithms, we have the good programs, we have infrastructure, the cloud that can provide us all the things that we need. I mean, 10 years back, 15 years back, you need to set up a data center. It takes like, you know, months and months. Now you can set up a data center within a few hours, as long as you know what you're looking at. Then the third point here is Internet of Things. Now we have connected devices, so we have more concise and more accurate data that was not available before. The last point is structured and unstructured data. We all understand what is a structured data. It is the data in the spreadsheet, in tables, in the rows and columns, right? And in the third industrial revolution, we solve the structured data problems. But the large amount of data is unstructured. Unstructured data means the videos, the documents, the PDF, the document repository, SharePoint, Google Drive, this drive that has like thousands of documents, but nobody goes and read it. Example I give as project manager, we do write a lesson learned document from the project, right? But nobody reads it. I have to do as a project manager. I do it. I put it on the repository. Nobody looks at it. Now with having that unstructured data access using AI, anybody can go and read that data and get some insight from it. And that's going to change the way the future will be. So quick overview of the generative AI landscape. We have Google has a product called Google Gemini. We will do a live demo with that. ChatGPT has a ChatGPT version that is available to the market. Cloudy has Cloudy 2 and 3 and now 3.5. that is available to the public, and now they have the web version of it. That's something I have not experienced by myself, but a lot of the people are talking really good value that they are getting from the Cloudy 3.5. Then we also have Meta Llama from Facebook, and Microsoft have their own product, which is called Copilot. Copilot uses the ChatGPT in the back engine, but the response you get from ChatGPT and Copilot are different, right? So there's some fine tuning that was done there as well. So with that, typically ChatGPT, Google Gemini, they offer these four different categories, right? Three to four different categories. So ChatGPT, we'll talk a little bit more because everybody is familiar with that one, has like 3.5, 4, and 4 Omni that was released last month. And, you know, 3 was free, then 4 was paid, now 4.0 is paid, and other two are free. Then we have the API interface. API interface is if you are writing a program within your organization that talks to ChatGPT to do something very specific function, in that case, you will use the API interface. Then there are custom GPTs. Custom GPTs are things that you would do to customize for your business or for your need, and you can publish it to the public, or you can just keep it private to within your organization. And then the last one is the enterprise GPT. this is where most businesses are trying to sell. So Microsoft is selling Copilot as enterprise GPT, Google is selling Gemini as enterprise GPT, and ChatGPT or OpenAI, they're also selling enterprise ChatGPT. That has all the security bells and whistles, IT governance, and all those things in place, right? So with that, now I'm going to change some gears and we will do a live demo of ChatGPT of generative AI. I need two volunteers to, one would be read the script of a sponsor and another one would read the script of the project managers. And this is a short meeting that I'm going to copy paste into those generative AI and ask number of prompts and see how it would interact in a real time. Okay. So do we have two volunteers that we can unmute and help me read the script while I can take a break and have a sip of water?
Yes, if you could type in the chat, I will unmute you. Anyone? Great.
Happy to, yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. Go ahead. Anyone, first one could be sponsored.
Okay.
The next one is from, yeah. Go ahead.
Layla. Right. I think I've given sent the request for audio. I think you can start speaking now. Let's see if we can hear it. Oh, it's still, I think the audio is still loading. Should be.
Hi, can you hear me?
Yep. Yep.
Yes. Thank you.
Great stuff.
Shall I start?
There you go.
Good morning. I appreciate your time. We're excited to get started on this website project for our insurance agency. The website is going to be a crucial tool for our agents. We need it to be user-friendly and efficient.
Henrietta?
Yes, do I carry on going?
Oh, Layla, sorry, I wasn't sure who was talking earlier. Layla, are you with us? Is your audio on?
Okay, Jay, why don't you act as a project manager?
Okay.
Go ahead.
Yeah, sure, I'll just read the other part then. Good morning, I'm eager to help you with this project. Let's start by outlining the key requirements. I understand we need both technical and business functionality.
The website should have an attractive professional design that reflects our brand. It must be responsive and mobile friendly to accommodate various devices.
Understood. The website should also have a user registration system for both clients and agents, allowing them to log in securely. What are the functionalities you envision for registered users?
Clients should be able to request quotes, submit claims, and access policy documents. Agents, on the other hand, need a portal where they can manage policies, communicate with clients, and generate reports. Additionally, we need to integrate a live chat feature for immediate customer support.
I see. For the backend, the system must be scalable, ensuring it can handle increased user loads as our agency grows. We'll also need robust security measures in place to protect sensitive data. What about integrations with external systems?
Absolutely. We need seamless integration with our internal CRM system for data synchronization. And we should also integrate with third-party insurance databases to provide accurate quotes and policy information in real time.
Got it. Do we have an approved budget for this project?
The board has initially approved the budget of $100,000. We should be able to showcase the new website at our annual conference, which is scheduled for November 28, 2024.
I'll engage with the web team to fully understand our resources capabilities, draft project charter, and come back to you by first week of April with project charter approval and draft project schedule. In terms of timelines, we should complete design by the end of April, development by the end of September, and testing by the end of October in order to be ready for the annual conference in November.
Yes, that will meet our timeline expectations for the annual conference. Make sure to engage web team, communication team, customer service, agent union, and IT team. Let's work together to make it a success.
Great.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much for volunteering and coming and speaking up. Okay, Good. So what we did in this meeting, I just put like a small script where we can showcase what was discussed in the meeting. And next, what we will do in ChatGPT will be, we will ask some prompts, right? So my first prompt would be, okay, hey, ChatGPT, I'm working as a project manager. I will enter a meeting transcription. Based on this meeting transcription, can you please provide me meeting summary under 50 words? Okay, so I will go to my ChatGPT screen now, and you guys can confirm if you can see my screen or not. Okay, now, can you see my ChatGPT screen? Yes, you guys can. Okay, so I'll put my prompt. I will enter a meeting transcription. I'm working as a project manager. Help me. And again, I try to sometimes reword it and reword Smith the prompt as a type. Help me as an AI assistant to provide response to my prompts. I will enter those prompts after I enter the meeting transcription. So I'm kind of setting up this stage, right? So what I'm gonna do, transcription. And what I will do is I will copy and paste. I'm gonna put this one in ChatGPT as well as I will put in the Google Gemini. So now you can see the Google Gemini here, and I'm gonna copy paste. Now I will go back to ChatGPT and say, sounds like a plan, go ahead and enter the meeting transcription. Then you can provide the prompts you would like assistance with, I'm happy to help. So let me just go and copy the meeting transcription. And I enter the meeting transcription here and then says, great, you have captured the detailed transcription for the initial project meeting. How can I assist you, right? I'll say that my first prompt was provide the summary under 50 words. Provide me the meeting summary under 50 words. Okay. So now under 50 words, it is saying the project involves developing user-friendly responsive website for an insurance agency, featuring client and agent portals, live chat support, integration with CRM and third-party databases. The meeting transcription that I copied from my text has like a $500,000 budget, not 100,000. So that's just the only difference. A $500,000 budget is approved with showcase plan for the annual conference in November 2024. So how many of you think that it captures the essence of the meeting in 50 words and it is accurate? Yes, Katrina, you're right. The budget is wrong. So it's in the transcript I provide as I copy paste as 500,000, not 100,000. Okay. Now, if I go to Gemini and I will put the same prompt, absolutely go ahead and share the meeting transcription. So I will enter the meeting transcription and let me go here and change the budget to 100. Okay. So it will give us the right response. So now provide me meeting summary in 50 words. Okay. So the sponsor initiated the website project for the insurance agency, emphasizing the need for user-friendly, secure, integrated platform. The project manager acknowledged the requirement and outlined the next step, including engaging stakeholders, developing project charter, establishing communication plan. The project has budget of 100,000 and target launch date aligned with the annual conference in November. So now you can see that both ChatGPT and Google Gemini gave me the 50-word summary. Both of them is a little different. Okay. Why it is different? Because each one of them has like a personality. Think of like you are working in an organization and you have five project managers. Every single project manager does things differently. So the way you do the project is different from the project manager sitting next to you, okay? So let's go back to the slides. So that was our first prompt. Now I'm going to do my second prompt that says, okay, based on same meeting transcription, can you please give me action items in a table format with action detail, action owner, and target dates? So this is something I like. You know, if you spend a lot of time in the meetings, you know that people talk about, okay, I will do this, I will do that. And sometimes as a project manager, we don't understand the technology or the details, right? So sometimes things get missed. And this is where this would be very, very useful. So I will say that based on the same meeting, can you please provide me action item table with following columns? And you can add whatever you like, right? So for example, the way I would prefer to do is, like, I need ID, I would say action details, and then I will say action owner, and then I will say target date. Okay, and I will copy the same prompt, so because I want to use this on the ChatGPT side, and let's see what Gemini does. So now it's telling me, number one, I, project manager, need to engage the web team and the stakeholder to assess internal capabilities and resources. And that should be done by July 11th. Now, sometime it picks up dates incorrectly, and that's something that we need to pay attention to, right? So all the dates are incorrect in this case. Develop detailed project charter, outlining scope, timeline, budget, and risk. Present project charter to sponsor for approval. Establish communication plan. Begin identification of project risk and mitigation. Now, if you look at these dates, it's putting all these dates at 11th of July and 18th of July. And the reason being is because in the meeting, we said that the project manager said that he will get back to the sponsor within 2 weeks for the project charter. So if you look from today's date, 2 weeks is July 11th. So that does make sense, right? So it kind of loses few contexts, but it kind of tried to build the context because we did not provide the meeting date when that meeting was actually happened. So let's see what the ChatGPT would do for the same prompt. Okay, I put this one in ChatGPT. Okay, so now it is saying draft project charter, project manager within 2 weeks, engage web team, resource capabilities within 2 weeks, coordinate with integration and internal CRM teams, IT team need to have that discussion, and this is to be announced or to be discussed. So all the dates here are to be discussed, and prepare for website for the showcase at annual conference, November 25th. So original date was November 28th, but it put like 3 days of contingency, and it gives me a table like this that I can copy paste, and I can put the dates that I like to, and that's something that I would take as a next step. So one of the comment just picked my attention, Katrina saying, in my PSO, these mistakes would have a performance conversation. Absolutely. So think of this ChatGPT and Gemini as your assistant. It is not a project manager. It is not replacing project manager. But it is doing things that would take you like 30 minutes to do. It can give you this table in like 1 minute, and now you can copy paste and make this table your own. You don't have to type all the things that were discussed in the meeting. And this is where the value is of the time saving and how we can do 80% of tasks and optimize our capabilities. Very good question, Katrina. Now in Gemini, I want to show you one more feature. Here it shows export to sheets. So if you click on that one, it can save this table into the Google Sheets. And from there, you can put into anything that you want, right? So that's something, okay, I got this table, all the dates are incorrect, but I can fix the dates, but all the tasks or actions are correct, or maybe need some fine tuning or some massage. But this is doing your 60% of your job, that to at least to type it in. right? So you don't have to type all those things that were discussed in the meeting. Now, going back to my prompts, I will put a next prompt that is based on this meeting. Can you help me define the resources do we need to complete this project? Okay, so I would like to understand the resource management. Based on this meeting, what project resources do we need to complete this project? So any response that ChatGPT or Gemini is giving to you, you're not going to copy paste as is, because your reputation would be at risk. As Katrina said, that, you know, this would have like a performance conversation, definitely. Think of this as an intern, somebody who knows something but makes some silly mistakes, and you need to keep a tab because your name will be on that paper. Now, if I put this prompt, what resources do I need? And let's see. So it is saying personal resources. We do need a project manager. We do need a web developers. Okay. We do need UI UX designers. We do need content creator. We do need quality assurance. We do need system admin and stakeholder representative from different teams. Okay, great. Now, as an experienced project manager, we know that resource does not mean just a human resource or the people resources, but could include other resources like budget, technology, and other things. So let's see what other resources it is giving us. It's saying we need a budget of $100,000. We need softwares and tools. We need some web development platform. We need a content management system. We may need a project management system. We need some communication tool. We do need some hardware and some additional consideration, third-party vendor, training, marketing, promotion. Now, think of this, like if you have to type all of this, how long it will take you? Is this 80% correct as whatever you would do in your organization? Most people say, yeah, this is 80% correct, right? Not 100% correct. But if I have to type this, it will take me 1 hour, right? So now AI is here to help you to get over that blank page syndrome that you don't have, you don't know where to start. You just know you have a draft, and that's easier to, you know, manage it from there rather than writing from the scratch. So this is what Google Gemini gave the answer. Now let's go and chat GPT and put the same prompt here and see what resources this would recommend. So again, similar context, it's saying human resources, project manager, web development team, UI UX, security specialist. So the other one did not mention about the security specialist, but this is required because in the meeting, we talked about the IT security issues, right? Quality assurance, CRM integration, data analysis, analyst, communication, marketing team, customer service, legal and compliance. And technical resources include web hosting service, software tool for development, for CRM, for security encryption, testing and debugging, third-party API. It did not mention the project management software that Google Gemini mentioned. So there are a few things that you will see that Gemini would do better than the ChatGPT. And sometimes ChatGPT could do better than Gemini. So think of this as like a, every tool is a separate project manager, and each project manager does some things differently. The budget is $500,000 because this is what I copy pasted in this one. So that makes sense that resources include human resources, financial resources, and technological resources. And remember, ChatGPT, Google Gemini, all these large language models and generative AI have passed the law exam, have passed the medical exam, have read the PAM book, have read the PRINCE2 and all the other project management material out there, and they understand how the projects do work. Okay, so with that, I will go to my fourth prompt. That is, I would like it to identify three high probability risks that I have to manage as a project manager. I'm not saying give me all the risks, because one thing I find is that if I say just give me the risk, it gives me a list of like 10 risks, and that may not be good risk. But if I say give me 3 risks or 5 risks, it gives me a little bit of a better quality responses there. So let me go back and say, great. Okay, based on this can you please provide me with three high probability risk on this project? And one thing I have noticed is that if you make spelling mistake or grammar mistakes, it's okay, it understands it. But sometimes if you make like a major grammar mistake or spelling mistake, it kind of gives you the wrong answer. So I made a mistake for the probability. I'm pretty sure it will catch up because it gets the context. So identifying high probability risk early in the project can help in planning effective mitigation strategies. Okay, good. Here are the three high probability risks for the website for insurance agency. Integration risk with existing system. Risk description. Integration with new website, with existing CRM and third-party insurance database, may encounter technical difficulties, such as data mismatch, incapabilities, delay in data synchronization. In fact, these challenges can delay project timeline. Mitigation, engage integration specialists early in the project. Second risk, it talks about the scope creep. I'm not going to read, but you get the gist what it's giving me a good ideas where to look for, right? Security vulnerabilities, because of the technical nature of the project, there could be some security risk that if I don't take care of that, that will cause a problem. Remember in the meeting, we talked about security because of the portal and the information about the policies would reside in those system. I'm gonna copy paste the same prompt here for Gemini and let's see what response it gives me. So the first, it says tight timeline and schedule risk. November conference deadline is significant constraint. Given complexity of the project, integration, custom features, multiple stakeholder, high probability of delay. If not managed carefully, this could lead to missing conference launch, which seems to be a key business goal. The second risk is scope creep. And the third risk is integration challenges. So both of them provide me good risk. And, so by default, ChatGPT provide me risk, impact, and mitigation, while Gemini only provide me the risk description. Now, if I would like Gemini to provide me the mitigation, I can simply type, can you please provide me a mitigation for each of these risks, okay? Now, if I do that, it will give me some mitigation strategies, right? So it's saying, how do I manage the time risk? How do like a detailed planning, start early, follow the agile methodology, prioritize, resource optimization, have a contingency plan regarding scope creep, have a clear scope definition, have a change control process, have a regular communication, do an iterative development, integration, early testing, get experienced resource, have a good vendor collaboration, and have some contingency plan, and then some additional mitigation strategies. So you see that out of the box in last 15, 20 minutes, we just give some prompt and it start giving us a lot of information that if I have to type, if I know all those things by my head, if I have to type, that will easily take me anywhere from 30 minutes to 1 hour because that will take my brain power. Now, if I have this, I can copy paste and I can make my own, but never ever copy paste and send it to your managers without reading it. That's a suicidal mistake at your workplace. So please don't do that. So with that, I'm gonna get to the last prompt, which is custom prompt, and we'll change the direction here. I will ask, what would you like to ask ChatGPT based on this meeting transcription? You can type. Okay, what question would you like to ask on this? Yes, so Lila is saying it's rare that we do the verbatim meetings. Nowadays, we do the action and risk. Yes, and that's the example that we saw in the second prompt I asked, give me the action item table. And that's something that's very, very useful for the project managers. So typically people would say, like in when I get to this prompt is like, okay, can it draft me like a statement of the work? Can it help me draft like a project charter? Can it create a risk risk diagrams? Yes, it can. Now, I think the risk mitigation is based on the BAU. A unique project would not be using toolbox provide mitigation. Okay, yes, you're right. So again, think of, as I said, that, you know, think of these responses for generative AI as a response from a smart intern that you recently hired. He or she understands the project management, but does not understand the details or is not experienced as a human. So somebody's asking, can I generate a Gantt chart or project timelines? Okay, good. Let's just do that. So I will go and first ask, can you help me put together a detailed project schedule? Okay, let's just do it two in steps. So I will ask this question to Gemini, and absolutely. So now it's giving me the project timeline. Okay, the task one, task two, task six. For the phase one, then it's giving me phase two. Okay, great. I will ask it to, can you please put this into a table or Google Sheet? Okay. And then we will see. Meanwhile, I'll go to ChatGPT. I'm going to put the same prompt and see what happens next. So now it's putting the same thing, right? It's putting the schedule for me. Okay. So each task is putting like 2 weeks, 1 week, and the details. Now, if I go back to Gemini, now you can see that Gemini put all these phases and all these tasks with start date and end date. And as you can see, you scroll down, you can see that I can export into Google Sheets. That means I can simply click here and it is now creating a spreadsheet for me, and I can click on open. Now here are all the tasks that are discussed there, and I can simply go and change the dates, and based on these dates, I can create the Gantt chart. Now I will simply ask, can you please create Gantt chart for these tasks? Now, typically I don't see like a really good response. I see an okay response in terms of Gantt chart creation, but we will see that how it does. Now it's saying it cannot create visual Gantt chart directly from this text. It can provide you the data. Yeah, because that's like a little step further, right? So it's not providing me that. But if I go to Gemini, ChatGPT, I have tried it. I think it has done few times, but not a good quality Gantt chart. So that's something that I'm not gonna rely on, but it's a good starting point, right? So again, think of this, how this ChatGPT would look like 2 years from now. And 2 years from now, definitely it can do the Gantt chart and much more to at a greater level. So let's see, it's analyzing, because it's generating an image, it's taking longer than the text. So the text responses are usually faster compared to the image responses. Okay, it's taking a little longer. Okay, let's come back to this. Okay, there you go. So it just did a Gantt chart for me, right? Now, this is what I find consistently, that the Gantt chart goes from lower bottom to upper bottom, while as a project manager, we are used to seeing from going top to the bottom, right? So that's just something that these tools need to improve. But if you look at this out of the box, this is good. This is a good visual. It's not the best, it's not 100% accurate, but it's a good starting point. I like the text component rather than the image component from these generative AIs. So let's go back to our slides. We have not much time left, so I'll just quickly go over what next. So do not use any AI model at work without having written approval. That's just my warning. Please do not do that, because that's could cause your, you may lose your job for that. Now, what you need to do is you need to build the AI governance within your team. You need some legal advisors, you need some privacy advocates, you need IT security, AI expert, and business area representative to help build that type of discussion. I am also leading a team at PMassistant.ai. If you like this one, you can go and download the AI prompt guide from Project Managers. That guide has over 80 prompts that you can just download and start using them. Also, once you download that, you will get to my wait list. Once we release the PM Assistant, you will be able to, you know, try it out. So our goal is to build the AI-powered project manager assistant for every project manager on every project. If you like this one, I have a couple of other Rise of AI series that you can follow me on the projectmanagement.com or go to my site or follow me on LinkedIn. You'll find those details up there as well. And the transcript will be available. So the final comment is, AI will assist project managers. It will not eliminate the project manager role. However, it will transform our role into strategic business enabler. So with that, I would like to open the floor for Q&A. Feel free to connect with me on the LinkedIn or send me an email if you have questions that I have not answered. And if you like this, I do run like a 4-hour AI masterclass. So if you want to learn more about that one, you can go to the Eventbrite page. That link is up there as well. So let's open the floor for Q&A. So I will go over the chat and...
Yes, thank you, Mashhood. I will just, in the meantime, put up the survey before I forget.
Thank you, Jay. So I'm just going over the chat. Feel free. Do you have any recommendation for acquiring the meeting transcript as to use as an input? Yes, my recommendation is, so Microsoft Teams, Zoom, Google Meet, any meeting collaboration tool that you are using has the transcription capability. So you start recording, it can start doing the transcript, and then you can do the rest from there. Now, the tool that I'm building, PMassistant.ai, this is where it can join all the meetings with you, do the transcription, and automatically do things for you and recommend you what you should do as you go to. Okay, I will disagree with this statement. It has replaced a planner if it creates a Gantt chart. Yes, it can create a Gantt chart, but not to the quality level. It will replace jobs, definitely. AI will replace jobs. The similar way in second industrial revolution, third industrial revolution, so many jobs were replaced. The farmer job is replaced by the farming equipment, but we have a lot of food available. There are like 8 billion people and we have food for everybody, right? So again, we are not getting out of the work. And now we have so many new professions that we never thought about, right? That never existed like 20 years back. So yes, I agree with you that, you know, it's opening more jobs. Okay, let me go next. Yeah, okay, Laila is saying, but they are not great transcript. Yes, so Zoom, Microsoft Teams, they are not great transcript. There are some other tools if you would like to try. One, I would suggest you to try a tool called fireflies.ai. And then there's another tool called Fathom, F-A-T-H-O-M. You can try that one. Again, they're not 100% accurate, but they get the job done to a level. And this is where I say that, you know, even if you let AI do your job, you have to read every single thing. Could it produce a project plan on example, Virto or Smartsheets? Okay, great. So Smartsheets have some integration with AI. And what people are doing is they are using Smartsheet and Zapier or make.com. And by building those custom workflows or automations, you can do those things. George is asking, do you think AI will have impact on PM methodologies such as waterfall and agile? Yes, definitely. I'm seeing that, you know, in my another demo, what I did is I uploaded like a workflow diagram and that diagram has one arrow missing, right? Like a decision box. Yes and no, the no box was missing. So I asked ChatGPT saying, hey, the diagram is missing this, what does that mean? And it was able to help me navigate saying, hey, you need to fix this and this. So in terms of process, you can put any process into ChatGPT and Gemini and ask them to fix it and they will give you good recommendation. Again, not 100% correct, but a good starting point. So, okay, any more questions? Okay. I think I catch all the questions. So my recommendation is to, you know, try these tools, you know, enjoy them, you know, work with them and see what works and what does not work with you. In terms of you would like to learn more, feel free to contact me on the LinkedIn. We'll be happy to have a chat or send me an email or anything that you have. Please share the details with me. Can you please repeat those tools? Okay, I'll just type them here. F-A-T-H-O-M, Fathom, and fireflies.ai. Is there any certification for this? So PMI has two courses for AI, but those are not certification courses. I'm not gonna go, I don't think we need to go and get the certifications, because what I believe is this is something, it's a tool, it's something that we need to use, right? Like typing skills, we need to know how to write a good prompt. So yeah, there could be some certifications, but I'm not familiar or aware of them. As I said, things are happening so fast, it's humanly impossible to know every single thing that is happening in the world of AI. So, and we need to be okay with that.
Just to add, BCS has a couple of AI certificates, foundation in artificial intelligence, but that's just general AI. It has nothing to do, it's not specialized for project management or anything, but they have a couple of certificates, and I think some other accreditation bodies are catching up on that too. Just to add, thanks. Yeah. I think George also asked, Mashhood, when do you think we will see more AI in the PM world?
Okay, so I'm seeing in the last 3 months, I start seeing there's a little bit of a transformation happening within the project management world. But so for example, if you go to, and I will type it here, if you go to raidlog.com, okay? That's a RAIDlog is a tool that as a project manager, we use to capture risk, action, issues, and decisions, right? They have an AI module where you can put your project description and it can generate the risk. And once you generate the risk and you put up the mitigation plan, then it will go and look what other content that you're providing and kind of does some recommendation on the fly. So you can download the AI prompt guide from PMassistant.ai and RAIDlog, I think it's RAIDlog.com. That is an AI tool for PMs. And what was the other thing? If we could analyze the data. Yes, it does. Laila is asking, can it analyze the data? Yes, it does. So ChatGPT 4, the paid version, and Gemini paid version. I'll just quickly show you the screen here. So if you see this clip sign here, if I do clip, I can connect with my Google Drive or Microsoft OneDrive or upload any document. I can upload PDF, Word document, diagram, spreadsheet, and it will just give you some output, right? It will tell you, you can ask questions about, like you can ask saying, hey, based on the spreadsheet, can you help me draft some graphs and charts? And similarly in Gemini, they have a plus sign here. So let me come on the screen. Yeah, and you, if you click on the plus sign, you can upload file, you can upload image, or you can attach with your Google Drive. So same function, right? So you can do those things. But again, this is available in the paid version. It's not available in the non-paid version. Okay, can you share the link of the second webinar for the Agile? It is on the project. Let me just do it quickly from here. I think I have it here. Contribution, webinars. I'll share the link right now. So there we go. Okay, where do I need to? Yes, this is here. Yeah. And if you go on this site, you will also, or if you go on my site, mashhood.net, you will also find some of my other talks and share my LinkedIn as well. So feel free to connect. And I think we have 1 minute left. So I would like to thank Knowledge Train for giving me this opportunity to speak with this wonderful audience. I really enjoyed the talk and the Q&A session. And thank you all. Looking forward to connecting with you. Thank you.
Thank you, Mashhood, for the great presentation. Thanks, guys, for participating. We'll be having webinars roughly every other month. And keep subscribed, and we'll let you know of the upcoming ones. Thank you.